Hey everybody, it's Jackson the Saxon here. Today we're going to learn with stone and the mo. So let's begin. Page one, stone. Stone. The equivalent of modern English, stone. Stone, stone. Notice the AI is not I. The AI is not A. The AI is oi, like boy, right? Oi. Stone. Stone. Here, I'm using it as this boy's name. Mau. 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 The W is articulated. We have to say the W, right? You can't just... There aren't any blends or anything like that. There are no silent consonants or silent vowels. Every single letter is pronounced. This is Mau. Mau means girl. But here I've used to... As a proper noun, it's this girl's name. But this is Mau. This is her brother, Stone. Stone and the Mau. Stone and the Mau. Notice this is and. And, right? Modern English and. You could probably figure that out. The I here at the end is articulated. It is pronounced, but is not enunciated. It's just there slightly. It's just... Right, you just mumble it out. So, and, right? Not andy, not andy. It's not Latin. We're not speaking Latin. We're not going. The key difference, one of the key differences between Latin and Germanic is that Latin, every single syllable is articulated the same, right? They're pronounced the same. Whereas in Germanic, the stress is placed on the first syllable. And the following syllables, we just slowly drop it off, right? Until like we get to the end, it's barely said at all. So let's move on. Here is the stone and here is the mau. One more time. Here is the stone and here is the mau. Here, right here, here. E-E. E-E. Now here, I say it, this long E, this long vowel, almost like an E-W. So the second E here almost takes on the W sound, right? Almost. Here. Here. The R also is not really like an English R. It's almost like a Scots R or something. I don't know. You put your tongue on the roof of your mouth. R, R. Here, here, here is the stone, and here is the mau, right? Here is stone, and here is mau. Oh, maybe you've noticed mau is related to the English word maiden, right? Or maiden. Here's the next page. Stone is the here, and the mau is the here. Stone is here, and mau. Once again, is here. Here is the sahandr. Okay. Hund, hund. Hound? Yes, exactly. So, hundr is related to, excuse me, modern English, hound. This part here, in the beginning, H-U-N-D, is the root, the base of the word. The part after, the A-Z, is the inflection, right? It explains to us, it tells us information about the word. So this here tells us that it's a noun, it's a masculine noun. The dogs are manly things, right? In Proto-Germanic, we see it as that. Everything's a manly thing or a feminine thing, or some things are neutered things, right? Dogs are manly things, so they are hundar, right? Also, preceding hound, we have the word sa. Sa. Sa means that, or the, right? That dog. Here is that dog. That dog that we are speaking of. Here is that dog. Now, sa also has many forms depending upon its place in the sentence, right? So just in here, in this book one, we're going to see so many different sa's, right? A bunch of them. So this is the masculine sa, and this is the dog is doing the action, right? It's called the nominative. So the dog's not having something done to it. It's the one doing, right? So it's sahandish. Sahandar. One more thing you can notice is the Z. I don't say it as a Z. I say it as an SH. And the reason is because if you listen to Icelandic, the R is back here, right? It's like a like in Icelandic, the word is handar, 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 right? Now, in Gothic, it's a s, handis, handis, handis. And also Latin, right? It's like canis or something, canis. I don't know. I don't know Latin, right? Anyway, it doesn't make sense to me that the sound that connects the Icelandic r and the Gothic s is a Z, right? Handis, handis, handis. I don't think so. I think if you took an S and you put your tongue back, put your tongue into the palate of your mouth while making an S sound, it comes out as a sh, 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 a kind of SH, right? It's a special sh sound, right? Sh is all about teeth. Sh is all about tongue placement. So you put your tongue on the roof of your mouth and you make an SH sound. You make an S sound. Sh. So here is the sahandar. Here is the sahandar. And I believe that is the accurate pronunciation of what we now write in Latin with a Z, right? The Germanic letter that we now write with a Z in Latin, but historically it's that trident looking thing, right? Handar. Here is the dog. Here is the Mair, and here is the Sahandar. Here is Ma, and here is the dog. Mo leokathi Sahandar, and the stone leokathi Sahandar. This is a little bit hard. Coffee. Like. You probably figured it out. It's like. Ma likes the dog, and stone likes the dog. But wait a moment. What's this? What's this madness? Sahandar. I just told you, this form meant the dog's the one doing the action. The dog's the one doing the action. Yeah. So, in Proto-Germanic, the word like is not an action performed by the person that's liking something. It's an action formed by the thing that is being liked. It's almost like is, like if we were to put the phrase, is being likable. Is being likable. That's the closest I can think about it. Okay, so here, the dog is doing the action. What is the dog doing? The dog is being likable. Being likable. And Mar, she's an indirect object. So she's not, the dog's not doing something to her. She's more like a room, right? That is having this happen. And she's the indirect object, the dative. We call this the dative case. She's the indirect object of his being likable. So, Mair lökathi sahandar. What it really means here is the dog is being likable and Ma is being affected by it. Right? The dog is being likable within Ma's mind, right? She is a place in which the dog is being likable, okay? And a stone, lökathi sahandar. The same for stone, right? So here, we could translate it as Ma likes the dog and stone likes the dog. But what we're really saying is a little bit different, a little bit different, right? It's more like the dog is being likable and Ma is the indirect object of that. And the dog is being likable and stone is the indirect object. Okay. I'll say the word one more time. Le koi fe. So le koi fe, right? Put it all together. Remember, the beginning takes the stress and then it fades out. Lekothi. Lekothi. Right? Lekothi. Ma lekothi sahandar. And the stone lekothi sahandar. Now, yay! You get to see something I just pointed out before. Sahandar. Look here. It's not sahandar anymore. Vaime handoi. It still means that dog, the dog. It's still the same word. But now, the dog is the indirect object of Ma's likability. right? So remember, the dog is the place. He is the room. And within this place, within this room, Ma is being likable. Right? Think of it like that. Thy my hundi lurketh in my, and thy my hundi lurketh in stay. Thy my, it means that. So sa is a masculine that, and it's called the nominative. The thing following sa is doing the action. Here, thy my is the dative masculine that. Right? So it's still masculine, but the thing following it is the place. It's the indirect object of the sentence, right? It's not doing something. It's not having something done to it. It's just the thing that's indirectly related to it. Okay? So, daime hande. Daime hande. Daime hande lurketh in my. And daime hande lurketh in stone. Bam. Mis lurketh in stone. So, mis, modern English, me. So, me. So, here, you think, oh, me, that's the object. Well, in English, the dative and the accusative, which is basically the object, have fused together, right? So, we can't really separate it. But they are distinct in Germanic. So, here, it's not stone is being likable to me, right? I'm not having this done to me. I'm just indirect. I'm just here enjoying stone's likability, right? Mis lurketh in stone. I like stone. Mis lurketh in mau. I like mau. Mis lurketh in hundas. The dog's likability is affecting me. Hier ist eine Böse. Eine. So if you look at this, remember when you see a new word, what do? Cut off the end of it as much as you can and just try to look at the beginning part, the beginning portion. Ein, 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 one, 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 and, right? There you go. Think somewhere between one and, ein, right? So ein is the word for one. And the ü following it here tells us that the word that will be after it is going to be a feminine noun. Right, so booth. Booth means shop. Booth, right? Booth. You can see booth. 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 Now, shops are feminine. Dogs are masculine. That's how it is. Look at a shop. Who likes to go to a shop? Women do. Okay? I don't know. Actually, there's very little connection to actual our ideas about masculinity and femininity in Proto-Germanic, but you know, some words are just masculine, some words are just feminine. There's no real reason. Some words obviously are like man is masculine, dog, maybe you could think dogs are tough, you know, dogs are tough things, so they're masculine. You know, girl is feminine. But a lot of words like a booth, I don't know. There doesn't seem to be a lot of logic to it. So, here is the eine Böse. Here is a booth. Pretty simple. Here is the eine Lochtre Böse. So, you see, I've taking two words here and put them together, it looks crazy. Like, what is that? Lochtre Böse. Lochtre Böse. But in English, we do the same thing, right? We just, Lochtre, it means toy. Lochtre. So, Loch means play. I'll explain it piece by piece. Loch means play. Play. So, the word play, the modern English word play, is distinct to English. And maybe Persian, I don't know, maybe Persian has it. But it's not an actual Germanic word. It's probably Celtic. And if it is Germanic, it's a late development that's just distinct to England, right? To the Anglo-Saxons. So the common word for play throughout the Germanic world is look, look, not like. You may think it's like what we were just speaking about a moment ago, like lick, but it's not lick, it's look. So look means play. Thra is suffixed to verbs and maybe some other words. And it's added to the end of these words, and it makes them into nouns, right? It makes them into a noun, and it means it's the tool that does this, right? So, like, if I'm plowing, and this is the tool that helps me plow, it's a plowther, right? Or something like that. I can't think of any words off the top of my head, but there are some you'd be like, oh, yeah, oh, that makes sense. I never thought of it like that. But, yeah, they're there. So here, lochtre, it means play thing, play tool, toy. booth, toy booth, right? A toy booth, a shop for toys. So booth again is still feminine, right? Even though lokthr is neuter, is not feminine nor masculine, is neuter. Booth is feminine, so the word one, ein, follows booth, not toy. It follows the ending. Here is the ein lokthr booth. Miss lokthr, so lokthr booth. Okay, pretty simple, right? The toy shop pleases me. The toy shop pleases me. And here is the toy shop, and the toy shop pleases me. Or I like the toy shop. Stein is the in. Deutsche Lokthr Büthe. Okay, we were talking about dative before. The indirect object. In. If you are in something, then that is an indirect object. Here, the main thing being said is stone is. He is. He exists. He exists. And where is he existing? He's existing inside of this toy shop, right? This toy booth, this toy shop. So Stein ist in deutsche Lokthr Booth. So because it's the date of the indirect object, we add an I to the end. Daimoy Hundoy Lokthr Stein. The dog likes stone, right? Well, here, because there is actually the stone is pleasing to the dog, basically. But the point is there, the dog is the indirect object. He's the indirect object of stone's likability. Well, here, the shop, the booth, is the indirect object of stone's being somewhere, right? Stone is the in. Dojo lokthr boothe. Okay. Dojo, daimoy, the same. They both mean that. Doizui is the dative case for feminine verbs. So because boots are feminine, we don't say daimoi, we say doizui. Oh, let me say it slowly so you can hear it. Doizui. Doizui. Okay, moving on. Mai is the in. Doizui lokthr boothui. Same. Sahandash is the in. Doizui lokthr boothui. The dog is in the toy shop. Stone here with thee, I in the lokthr. And the mire here with thee, I in the lokthr. Okay, stone here with thee. Can you guess the meaning? Has, good job. Stone has a toy, lokthr, right? Now because toys are neuter, is oin. Before was oinu. Here's oin, right? Because neutered. It's not a feminine noun. Now it's a neuter noun. So it's oin. Stone here with the oin lokthr. And the mire here with the oin lokthr. Stone has a toy and ma has a toy. Stone here with the oin ball. Stone lokthr sabolish. Okay. Stone has a ball. Stone likes the ball. So, einen ball. Balls are masculine. Balls are masculine. And yes, they do have the meaning of testicles too, even in Germanic, right? Even in Germanic. Do you know, like in Iceland, they won't even say ball because it's considered rude to say the word ball. Just, it has no other meaning at this point. The word ball only means testicle. So yeah, it's a masculine word. So stone has a ball. Stone likes this ball. Or the ball is pleasing to stone, right? Because stone is the indirect object. The ball's likability. It's crazy, but you just need to get used to this like. Stone is a proper noun. So here I'm just going to keep it the same. I'm not going to change its form. But for non-proper nouns, you'll notice the form will change. The stone here and the stone here would not be the same, right? Because here, stone's doing the action. Stone has a ball. So this is the masculine A, and it's the accusative A. It's the object. It's having something done to it. It is being had. It is being had. So stone here with thee, I know the ball. Stone look with thee, it's a ballish. Here is the sahandar. Sahandar here with thee than the ball. Here is the dog. The dog has the ball. Here you can notice the dog, sahandar. He's the nominative, the one doing the action. He is being. And here, than the ball. Than the ball is the one having something done to it. This than is also that. It's also the word that, but it's the that for the object, the objective at, right? It's the accusative at. Objective, accusative, right? Same thing, basically. It's the accusative that. So it's than. Sa, than, daimai. These are the three masculine words for that we'll use. So, sahandash, right? Sahandash, the dog. And it's the dog's the one doing something. Daimai hundai, the dog. And the dog is the indirect object, right? And danu. Danu, what was the word? Honda. Yeah. Danu honda. Danu honda. With no sh sound. Danu honda, right? It means the dog. And the dog is the one having something done to it. Danu honda. So remember, these are the three main cases you'll need to remember. Right, there's also the genitive, the possessive, and stuff like that. And there's the instrumental, it's a tool. And the vocative, you know, don't worry about it. We'll slowly build up. Right now, just remember these three. The one doing something, the one having something done to it, and the indirect object is just the place where it's happening. So, than, sa, they're both the same exact word, just with a different form. Here's the dog has the ball. Here is the ayna trewe. Sabalish is the ayn daima trewe. Okay? You can see this ayn. So maybe you figured out, hey, trees are neutered, right? They're not masculine or feminine. They're neutered. But here we have daimai. Daimai is the same as for the dog. And we know that the dog is masculine. Well, in this case, The dative for the masculine and the neuter is the same. So, daimai hundai and daimai trewai. Right? Daimai hundai, daimai trewai. They're the same for the dative case, but not for the other cases, the accusative and the nominative. So, here is the ayna trewai. Sabalish is the in daimai trewai. Here is a tree. The ball is in the tree. Stoin is the in daima trewe. And the mai is the in daima trewe. Stone is in the tree. And ma is in the tree. Here is the stone in daima trewe. Stone here with thee, than the ball. Here is stone in the tree. Stone has the ball. Okay? Hope you enjoyed the video. Bye-bye. If you have any questions, tell me in the comments and I will get back to you. Also, this is my first video. I've never blogged or YouTubed or whatever before. So if there are any problems, any suggestions, please, you're more than invited. You are more than welcome to tell me so I can improve and I can get better and better at this. And hopefully, we can all learn Germanic together and celebrate our ancestry. That's all. Jackson the Saxon is out.